San Diego, how's everybody doing? Thank you for your patience. If you can, please come closer. Before we start, I just really want to acknowledge the labor of love. If you can please give a big round of applause for PY and Pastor Q, who have been here under the heat. They put the sound together, would have took 2 hours, and I just want them to know and feel. So I think you guys can be louder than that. Give them some love. Thank you very much, Pete and Pastor Q. My name is Mike Delaroche. I'm going to pass on the mic. But first, I just want to say welcome to the RFK Human Rights Award ceremony to honor one of our very own, Guerline Jozef.
Hi, everyone. My name is Shirley. I am with the Haitian Bridge Alliance. We are so, so happy to be here. We are here to celebrate Guerline, to celebrate the work that she's been doing for at least the past 5 years of her life. But what's amazing, it's like unlike other candidates, Guerline didn't want to have a fancy event. She wanted this award to show what exactly she's doing, what she's fighting for, the people that she's fighting for. And that's why this award ceremony is basically a call for action where instead of going to the U.S. Senate to have a fancy event, we want to send a message to them. And the message is clear. We all know it is a very simple message. To end Title 42, to stop deportation and protection for all.
Hey, everyone. I'm Wade McMullen. I work for Robert F. Kennedy Human Rights, and we're so happy to be here today with you all and to bring the RFK Human Rights Award outside of the halls of Congress and to the people, for the people, and for everybody that is in there right now. Let's give a very loud yell of solidarity with everybody who is unjustly caged right behind us right now by the U.S. government. We are here for them. We are here to uplift Guerline and the work of the Haitian Bridge Alliance and the work of all of you are doing to shut down ICE detention, abolish ICE, and to stop the Haitian deportations in Title 42 and actually bring justice back.
So we're going to thank our partners, the Racial Justice Coalition of San Diego. Woo! Detention Resistance, SCLU San Diego. And Imperial Countries, Freedom All San Diego. Empedam, Welcome with Dignity. Espacio Migrante. Community Asian Solidarity. Collective, California Poor People's Campaign. North Country Equity and Justice Coalition. We are all we got San Diego. San Diego. Showing Up for Racial Justice San Diego, MAS, PACE, AFSC, United Domestic Workers of America, San Diego and Imperial Countries, Women at Work, California Collaborative for Immigration Justice, and many more.
First off, I just want you all to look around at each other. This is what beautiful love and resistance and transformation looks like. We also acknowledge, though, we're on the traditional land of folks that have been here for generations. So I just want a really big round of applause for Janika from the Vieja Band of Kumeyaay. I didn't want to mispronounce it, y'all, because it's very important.
Okay, everyone, just here to introduce my cousin Bobby Wallace from the Barona Band of Mission Indians. He'll be here to do the Kumeyaay Land acknowledgement because we do want to recognize that we are on Kumeyaay Land.
Hey, you guys, how's it going? You know what? And when my cousin asked me to come down, hell yes, because this is what it's all about. People getting together, people trying to make change. We can't do this shit without the younger people knowing and making the change. You got it? Yeah. You know, let me do a little land acknowledgement, actually, in respect to my ancestors. So if you guys could just tone it down just a hair. And, you know, I want to thank the Creator for all of us being alive to be here today. the air, rains, and acknowledge the land that we live upon. Acknowledge Mother Earth, acknowledge inhabitants, including water that's alive, and all the animals, the bugs, and the dirt, and the lightning, and the thunder, and the clouds, and everything that makes this place so great for us to be alive on. Our ancestors were here. We pray to those ancestors, because we know they're with us. You know, we got to hear the laughter and love of our grandpa, our grandma, our mom, and they got to hear their grandpa, mom, and dad, and so on, all the way up the line. So we know they're with us. They're in our DNA. We give thanks for us to be here, to be able to have people hear the message for all the wrongs that shit, or all the wrongs that's going down. Excuse my language, creator, for all the stuff that's going down here and all across Turtle Island and all across the world. Thank you, creator, again, for giving us life and us being here today. Thank you. Hope. Hey, you guys, so, you know, this is something that, you know, all the younger people, you know, they can see, and we're setting an example, you know. And I see a lot of younger faces in here. You know, there's some of us folks that have traveled and seen the abuse and the shit put upon people, and that sucks. You know what? It really sucks. You know, as we move out through this era in time, we're the ones that can make a difference of what the hell's going to happen in the future. And I see it right here today. You guys, give a big yell for yourselves. And that is the truth. You know, if we go by and turn our head, we're just as guilty, you guys. So I know everybody wants to hear, you know, a little bit from everybody. And you know what? Thank you for honoring me with your time so I can be here with you guys. So much love, and truly much love to each and every one of you. Thank you. And this is my little cousin.
Another big round of applause.
So are you guys ready for some music? Are you guys ready for some music? Okay, I'm gonna make you work for it a little bit. When I say deportation, we say no. Deportation? No. Protection? Yes. Protection? Yeah. Deportation? Protection? Deportation? No. Protection? So it's such a pleasure for me to introduce the amazing Wyclef Jean. Are you guys ready to dance? Guerline wanted to have Wyclef here today because Wyclef is one of the artists who put Haitians on the map when it wasn't cool for us to be Haitian. So we're really proud to have him on stage with us. Please, a big loud scream for Wyclef.
Joe Biden, if you're listening, pay close attention. Deportation needs to stop. We need to end Title 42, yeah. Why? If I was president, I'll get elected on Friday, assassinated on Saturday, yeah. Buried on Sunday. And on Monday, everybody goes back to work, yeah, like nothing happened. It's just an ordinary day, yeah. Instead of spending billions on the war, we can use that money, yeah, so we could feed the poor. I know some so poor, yeah, when it rains, that's when they shower, screaming, fight the power, yeah, that's when the vulture devours. Mr. Biden, I know you're listening. Stop Haitian deportation, yeah. Title 42 needs to end. What's happening to the Haitian people is inhumane. If I was president, I'll get elected on Friday, assassinated on Saturday, buried on Sunday. Then on Monday, everybody goes back to work, when nothing happens. It's just an ordinary day. I know my Haitians can hear me behind the fence. I know ISIS is listening. Have a little compassion for my people behind the fence. And let me sing something for them in Creole. Sou gen zore tande, sou gen bouche pale, si e pa sa, peyi non li pral koule, kan kou yon bato ki plein refije, ayisyen yo chache bon Dieu, encore. Sou gen zore tande, sou gen bouche pale, si e pa sa, peyi non li pral koule, kan kou yon bato ki plein refije, ayisyen yo chache bon Dieu, tande. Jimmy Shekai, gade tout se ti moun, père a prié, mais yo pas précisité, non, non, maman relaye, mais cadavre pas qu'attendre, non, zingle d'où passe, moi tende blow, 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 blow. Sou gen zorey tande, sou gen bouche pale, si e pa sa, peyi non libral koule, kan kou yon bato ki plein refije, ayisyen yo chache bon Dieu, encore. Sou gen zorey tande, sou gen bouche pale, si e pa sa, peyi non libral koule, kan kou yon bato ki plein refije, ayisyen yo chache bon Dieu, encore. Yele, 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 kriye, 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 peuple a pemande. Qui laisse avoir changé? Yele, yele, yele. Crier, crier, crier. Peuple a demandé. Qui laisse avoir changé? If they wanna know what bridge I'm crossing, it's the Haitian Alliance. If they ask you which bridge I'm crossing, tell them it's the Haitian Alliance. Yeah. Go high now. And to my young soldiers that says, who's this cool guy up here with the glasses on? And what generation do he come from? I'm so strong, I reinvent myself over and over again. Over and over again. DJ Khaled gave me a call. I told him I'm going to the Haitian Bridge Alliance. He said, why, Clef, do the song you gave me permission to use? I was like, a little something I wrote for Carlos Santana. Maria, Maria. She remind me of a West Side story, yeah. Growing up in Spanish Harlem, yeah. She living the life just like a movie star, yeah. Maria, Maria, yeah. She fell in love in East LA, yeah. To the sound of the guitar, yeah. Play by Carlos, eh? Stop the looting, stop the shooting, pickpocketing on the corner, while the rich is getting richer, the poor is getting poorer. Set me and Maria on the corner, taking the waste to make it better. And I look up in the sky, hoping that there's a paradise. Everybody like a Ola Binga, Mama Chella, Mama Chella, a Ola Binga, Mama Chella, East Coast, a Ola Binga, Ola, hey, 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 San Diego, Maria, Maria, yeah. She remind me of a West Side Story, yeah. Growing up in Spanish Harlem, yeah. She living a life just like a movie star, yeah. But Maria Mario, yeah. She fell in love in East LA to the sound of the guitar, yeah. Played by the Haitian Alliance.
One more time for Wyclef Jean. So we are at the RFK Human Rights Award ceremony, and historically they've always done it in the Senate, in the United States Chamber. But I want to give mad love and credit to Kerry Kennedy, the executive director of RFK Human Rights, because rather than going to DC, she wanted to make sure that we were here with the people, for the people. And if we can, call and response for all the Haitians behind me, for all the Cameroonians behind me, for all the Mexicanos behind me, for all the Central Americans behind me, for all of our loved ones behind me. Say, we love you. Let them hear it. We love you. One more time. We love you. One more time. We love you. Ladies and gentlemen, Kerry Kennedy.
Thank you. I am so happy to be here. Are you happy to be here? Yes. Thank you, Wade. Thank you, the amazing Wyclef Jean. How lucky are we to be with Wyclef? And most of all, the goddess, Guerline. Okay. I have a few things to say. I'm going to put this here. Now, I have to tell you something. I showed this speech to my daughter, Cara, and she said, you know, that reminds me, I was in Washington once, and they had all of these people lined up in front of the White House, and somebody was giving a very long speech, and one of these guards started to faint, and all of a sudden, there was another guard right there who caught him before he fell to the floor. And isn't that amazing? And Cara said she told that to a friend of hers who was a guard, and he said, yeah, well, if people are standing long enough, they're going to faint. And so this is a really long speech. So try not to faint. If you see somebody fainting, go over to them and catch them before they faint. Okay, I'm just warning you right now. So RFK, also I wrote a poem that is inspired by all of you and especially by Wyclef. This is it. President Biden, welcome Haitians, stop Title 42 deportations, by Kerry Kennedy. Okay, so RFK Human Rights was founded by my father's family and friends in 1968 to carry forward unfinished work on social justice. I'm honored to be joined here today with the RFK Ripple of Hope Award laureate, Wyclef Jean. The last time we were together in person, we were walking through one of the poorest and most violent neighborhoods in Port-au-Prince, where Wyclef was helping young men transform their lives, and I'm so happy to be reunited with this hero today. Thank you. But most of all, I'm proud to be back together with Guerline Jozef, my hero. Guerline is a warrior. She is a true servant of others. She epitomizes faith in action and believes that nothing is impossible with God. She is the co-founder and executive director of Haitian Bridge Alliance, a coalition of Haitian nonprofit organizations and activists who work to protect the civil and human rights of Haitian communities in California and beyond. Guerline is a leader of faith in action and the immigration justice movement. Along with everything else, she works to prevent child sexual abuse in Haitian immigrant communities. Thanks to Guerline, the plight of thousands of immigrants have been made better. But so much more can be done if others join her in her brave fight and that's why we're here with you today. The last time I saw Guerline, we were under the International Bridge in Del Rio, Texas, where 14,000 women and children, mostly, and men, mostly of Haitian descent, sought refuge in the United States. The scene was truly terrifying. I saw tents made out of bamboo poles and cardboard, sheathed in old skirts and t-shirts. I saw fathers holding infants, mothers cradling toddlers, and women and men who risked everything because of their belief in the promise and compassion of our great country. But these families were met not by the love that is the best of America, but by a phalanx of guards and guns and gargantuan SUVs, some emblazoned with white supremacist insignia. They were seeking the protection they are entitled to as asylum seekers under U.S. and international law. And yet, they have been subjected to unspeakable violence, discrimination at every step of the way. Most shamefully, they have suffered horrific acts of racism at the hands of the United States government, including assaults by Border Patrol agents on horseback. One could not help but think about those dogs and horses unleashed on civil rights activists in Birmingham in the 1960s. The U.S. government emptied the Del Rio encampment by rapidly deporting as many people and families as possible, including those who have witnessed or experienced the abuse by law enforcement that is currently under investigation. So they picked them up, and they disappeared, all the witnesses. I love President Biden. I truly do. And I know these are not his values. So it pains me to see this. This administration must act now to end these atrocities at our border and live up to the values they profess, starting by immediately halting all deportations to Haiti, which is still reeling from a presidential assassination, a 7.2 magnitude earthquake, and a series of powerful tropical storms. Currently, the U.S. State Department warns against visiting the country, stating, quote, "Do not travel to Haiti due to kidnapping, crime, civil unrest, and COVID-19, unquote, placing it in the same high warning category as Afghanistan, Yemen, and North Korea. How can we be sending over 8,000 children and women and men to Haiti right now? The mass expulsions of Haitians and other Black asylum seekers and refugees violates the prohibition against non-refoulement, a principle of international and U.S. refugee law that prohibits any form of return where an individual's safety or freedom remains at imminent risk. The administration must immediately rescind the Trump administration's draconian Title 42, a policy invented by white supremacists and Trump presidential aide Stephen Miller that was clearly invoked to illegally turn away individuals seeking asylum under the guise of a public health mandate. In fact, there was no COVID health emergency at Del Rio. The doctor in charge of the Del Rio Bridge told Guerline and I that they tested everyone there and found no cases of COVID. Using Title 42 to expel asylum seekers there was unlawful. In order to realign ourselves with foundational principles of international humanitarian and U.S. law, we must welcome all asylum seekers through an equitable process that upholds the human and civil rights of those seeking protections. We just came from Tijuana, where we spoke with many Haitian families. The stories they told us were harrowing. Now just imagine this. You survived the earthquake in Haiti in 2010. Your house and all your belongings were destroyed. You lost much of your family. Not just your family, but your neighborhood. Not just your neighborhood, but your entire city. Then you figured out how to take your kids and maybe your husband and make your way to some country in Latin America that you couldn't find on a map where they don't speak your language. And you figured out how to negotiate housing and health care and enroll your kids in school. And then you hear you might be reunited with family members already established in the United States if you can make it to a place called Del Rio, Texas, wherever the hell that is. You know what we should do with the women and the men and the children who figured out how to get herself and her family all the way to that bridge in Del Rio? We should make her the head of IBM. We should welcome all of those people. You know what would happen if we welcomed all 14,000 Haitians into our country? You know what would happen? We would be stronger and kinder and more hardworking, more determined country with a stronger commitment to family and freedom and peace than ever before. That's why all of you are here today, in person and remotely. Shortly after Del Rio, I had dinner with my mom. She's 93 years old. And we talked about what we saw in Del Rio, and we talked about human rights missions to Haiti that she had gone on advocating for health care and the right to water. And she asked what RFK Human Rights was doing to address the abuses of Haitian refugees. And I told her that within a week, our brilliant lawyers filed Freedom of Information Act requests with 28 federal government entities. We sued the U.S. government at the Inter-American Court for Human Rights and petitioned for immediate precautionary measures to stop the flights to Haiti and to allow immigrants to exercise their right to apply for asylum. But nothing made my mom more proud when I said, "We are coming together with the RFK Ripple of Hope Award laureate Wycliffe Jean, Leadership Council member John Boyer, our incredible staff, Wade McMullen, Angelita Bayans, Sierra Ewart, Eli Dreyfus, Carrie Casper, Christy Ueda, and most importantly, all of you in San Diego to present the Robert F. Kennedy Human Rights Award to Guerline. At RFK Human Rights, we believe those closest to the problem are closest to the solution. No one is closer to the challenge of the crucible of immigration, poverty, and race than Guerline Jozef. For Guerline, this fight is not an abstract policy decision. She is on the ground, in the courts, in the camps, on the front line. I have witnessed her faith in action. In Del Rio, along with everything else going on, Guerline noticed a mother holding a baby who was very still. Very, very still. Far too still. The mother was in shock. The baby was dying. Guerline convinced that mother to let her take the child, who was then airlifted to Houston, got the nutrition and care she desperately needed, and miraculously survived. That's Guerline working on the big issues, but always, always doing so from the perspective of the person right in front of her. Guerline is now the godmother of that child. Mother Teresa was asked, "How do you help so many people?" And she said, "You help one, and then another." That's Guerline. Each one is precious. Each one is deserving. Each one is a child of God. Guerline, know that we are standing beside you in this fundamental fight for dignity. With every march, with every vigil, with every single immigrant story told, you are creating hope for the just and peaceful world that my father envisioned for all of us. I am so very proud to present this heroine of human rights with the Robert F. Kennedy Ripple of Hope Award. Oh, Robert F. Kennedy Human Rights Award.
Mesa, how are we doing? Pour frère Maxime, qui derrière nos prisons, nous voulons ça y entendre, nous voulons ça y connaître que nous là avec you. Nous tendez, nous voyons et nous pas quitter. For my brothers and my sisters who are caged behind us in Otay Mesa, a private detention center. We want them to know that we are here, we hear them, we feel them, we see them, and we are here for them and with them. It is a blessed honor and privilege to stand before you to receive this award, to see my brother Wycliffe Jean, who has turned the course of the Haitian American community. When he came out with the Fugees, we were no longer hiding. We were able to reclaim 1804 and said, yes, yes, we can. We can continue to lead the fight for freedom and liberation, not just for our people, but for all people. And as I'm standing here thinking about what Haiti represents, after years of slavery, we fought the biggest army of the time. We fought Napoleon, y'all, and we won. Now imagine enslaved people taken from different tribes of Africa come to a place where we are dismantled. Our families dismantled. That's why I am also calling for the African diaspora, a call to a family reunion. And thinking when my forefathers, whose blood ran through my veins, fought to create a nation, a people, a language, and we said, upon this land, we shall be free, and we shall be free indeed, no matter what your ethnicity, your color, your country of origin. If you stand foot on Haiti, you will no longer be owned by another person. This is the idea that we continue to fight for today. This is the idea that the United States is saying that they want to uphold. When I'm looking in the eyes of Christina Griffin, a warrior leader descended of enslaved people, and I'm looking in the faces of my parents, justice warriors who put their lives on the line, descended of enslaved people. We are here to say enough is enough. As black bodies continues to travel through countries, as you heard from Kerry Kennedy, losing their lives only with hope, a hope that the life that they have been searching for, they will find here, a country that the Haitian people have helped to build. A country we are never welcomed in, yet we continue to die for. As I stand before you today, we want President Biden, the Vice President, Secretary Mayorkas, to listen to the cry of the people to end Title 42. There is no reason for us to continue the same policies that came from the previous administration that I shall not name. If we continue those same policies, those same ideologies, those same racist narratives, how can we build better? How can we save the soul of America while we see under the bridge in the Rio the inhumane treatment of little black girls and little black boys simply with their parents carrying food? We all saw the pictures. We saw the videos. Those men were carrying what? Food. Because under the bridge, on U.S. soil, food was not being provided for them. So today, I want to say thank you again for this amazing honor as I join the ranks of people that I cannot even say their names. And on behalf of the Haitian community, on behalf of the Cameroonian community, the Mauritanian community, on behalf of all those migrants who are still in search for a better life, thank you. What we say is, we at the Haitian Bridge Alliance, we went to the border because we heard there were Haitians. We arrived, we saw Haitians. We also saw Cameroonian. We also saw Mexicans. We saw Chinese. We saw people from Sri Lanka. We saw people from all over the world. Yes, we went for the Haitians, but we stayed for everyone. And we will continue to fight for everyone. And I also want to acknowledge some people I know Shirley didn't acknowledge before. If we missed you, please forgive me. Immigration defenders? IMDEF? My sister IMDEF? Jack? Law Lab, Ayla, Raices represent, Revolve Impact, our brothers and sisters here on the ground who have come together with Christina. We want people to understand from the every nook of the walls, on the hills, in Congress, in the White House, hear us clearly. We are not giving up. We together as a country, as a nation, as a people, must welcome others with dignity. And we stand against every internal violence and every external violence upon the bodies of people. As black people migrate, understand we have no safety. It doesn't matter where we find ourselves, we are not safe. It is time that the mountain comes down, that we walk and we say, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last. So these are the people who are responsible. Who are responsible for me being here today. And I always say I hated public servants because I watched my dad as the mayor of our city in Haiti, and as he continued to lead people in our nation and giving everything he had. And when children will come to me and say, oh my gosh, your dad is amazing. And I say, well, he's more your dad than mine. Because he makes sure he takes care of the community first. And my mom, as a businesswoman, she literally gave everything that she instead of selling her goods, she gave them away. So because of that, I didn't want to be part of a movement that I saw there were a lot of suffering. But God knows, here we are. And Wade, Shirley, Mike, Josiane, Philip, our board members, Roberta, where's Nicole? Don't hide, girl. Nicole, Dalancier, Martine, Jay, Marie Camel, we are here. We are still here. There is no giving up. And President Biden said in himself, the Haitian community never gives up. So he knows that we are going to keep on pushing until we get protection for those who are most vulnerable. So as we say in Haiti, un pil me chay palou. I want you to repeat after me. Un pil me, un pil me, un pil me. It simply says many hands lighten the load. Thank you.
One more big round of applause. So we started with song and we're going to end with song. We have an incredible group of organizers, human rights activists, right out of Skid Row in Los Angeles. I want to say thank you to LA Camp for coming and blessing us. I want to say thank you to RFK Human Rights. I want to say thank you for Haitian Bridge Alliance. Thank you, Revolve Impact. Thank you, everyone who made today possible. And thank you, everyone here. If I could please, please, all of us have a phone. Please tag President Biden and Kamala Harris and hashtag end Haitian deportations and end Title 42. This can happen and it can happen now. So please put your hands together for one of my favorite bands, the Freedom Singers from Skid Row.
Yo, while we get this cracking, can I hear y'all say, we ain't free? We gonna try that again, San Diego. We know y'all can get crunk. We ain't free.
We ain't free.
Until all Haitians are free.
We ain't free.
We ain't free. Until all Haitians are free.
Until all Haitians are free.
We ain't free. Until all black bodies are free.
Until all black bodies are free.
We ain't free.
We ain't free.
Until the ravages of plantation capitalism repairs and gives back all that it has stolen. Can y'all repeat that? Or was that too goddamn much? We ain't free!
We ain't free!
As long as anyone is in cages.
As long as anyone is in cages.
Check it out, y'all. I'm gonna turn it over to the Minister of Culture, K.O. We gonna bless y'all with a little song we created.
Good afternoon, y'all. How y'all doing? I know y'all can do better than that. Give me some noise out there. These are the Freedom Singers from Los Angeles Community Action Network in Skid Row, downtown, where our executive director, Mr. Pete White, you just heard from. Give it up for Mr. Pete White. The song we're gonna do for you is an original piece that was written upon inspiration from the deaths of Brother George Floyd and Sister Breonna Taylor. But we think it resonates beyond that. It's entitled, I Can't Breathe. And we have the Freedom Singers Quartet doing I Can't Breathe. We need y'all support with us. Y'all with us? Woo.
Saying to your only son, straight A student. Son, you can't be too free out here. Your skin and your spirit causes way too much fear. You can't just live out loud, even though you make me so proud. And try to be mindful of what you see, so you never have to call and say to me, I can't breathe. Oh, oh, oh.
You raised your daughter with spirit and heart to appreciate laughter, music, and art. She says, Mama, I'm leaving home. You're happy, but worry about her alone. Then one day after working so hard, cops came marching across her front yard. Without a thought, the shots rang out. She never had a chance to cry out, I can't sleep.
Oh, I can't sleep.
No, I can't sleep.
No,
I can't sleep. Hear me, please.
I'm meant to be. Take your knee off me, 'cause I can't breathe.
I can't breathe, I can't sleep. I can't breathe, I can't sleep. I can't breathe.
D-Rock, give it to us.
He's an old selector. Put your hand in the air like this. Come on. Don't think this is what I'm wishing I'm a star. Sitting on the back like I'm a youngster. Committing petty crime because I'm not a job. Commission coming out the job and I go. I take the roster. Put down the gun, the Uzi, the machine. 16 years old and I taught magazine. No more G.I. Joe with the Kung Fu brick. A man is 9mm with the extra clip. Open up the Bible and read a script. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not murder. Eternal damnation, you don't blunder. Give thanks and praise to the Father. Yes, him are the heaven and the earth rightful ruler. The beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega. Get your youth and them shoot no better. Why the youth and them a kill them little brother? Lord, freedom singers, let's go. Turn them down. Turn down Babylon, come.
Those like this says, what do? You fight when they take your rights.
What do? You fight when they take your rights.
What do? You fight when they take your rights.
Say,
what do? You
fight
when they take your rights. Say it with us, and what do?
We can't hear you. We can't hear you, San Diego.
What do you do?
Yeah. There it is. One more time, San Diego.
What do you do?
Yeah.
When they take your
I think they're almost ready, KO.
What do you do? When they... Next.
next one goes like Woo. This. It says, what do we do tonight? Y'all ready for that one? Let's do it then. What do we do tonight? Let's do it again. Unite. And what do we do? What do we do? Come on, yeah, say it. And what do we do? Unite. Next line goes, says, what do we do? Unite. Lift your voice up. Lift your voice and speak the truth. Lift your voice and speak the truth. Say that. Lift your voice and speak the truth. Come on and lift your voice and speak the truth. Come, lift the voice and speak the truth. Come on again. Lift your voice and speak the truth. What do you do? You fight. Say we fight. And what do? We fight. What do? We fight. When they take your rights, what do? Unite. So we're gonna say we fight and unite. We need y'all with us, right? What do? We fight. What do? Unite. We got it again. Say, what do? We fight.
Let them hear you, y'all, in the hotel mason detention.
What do we do? Unite.
Y'all gotta get louder than that. Come on, y'all.
What do? We fight. Come on, we fight.
One more time.
And what do we do?
Unite.
Good. Let's say we fight again. What? And what do we do? We fight. What do you do? And what do you do? Unite. It goes like this. The next part goes like this. And I want y'all to do this part with me. Oh, Haiti. Oh, Haiti. Say that part for me. And oh, Haiti. Come on, come on. Oh, Haiti. Oh, Haiti. With you, oh Haiti, we feel you too, oh Haiti, pain so profound, oh Haiti, never keep you down, oh Haiti, we stand with you, oh Haiti, we feel you too, oh Haiti, pain so profound, oh Haiti, never keep you down, say what do we do? And what do? D-Rock, take it away.
Yo, yo, give it up for D-Rock. He's been back here patient. He's been waiting to bless y'all. Give it up. We want to dance in the streets. We want to dance for freedom, y'all. Pump them up over your head. Put your fists up in the air. D-Rock, take it away, loved one. Wyclef, give it up for Mike De La Rocha. Give it up for everybody who took their time out today for freedom and liberation, who said we're going to come and stand and face the state and say, let our people go. more and more groups coming up that's going to holler at us. It's going to give you an opportunity to lean in and join in. Because while we stand here today, the most important thing is to join an organization or to join the struggle. So you're about to hear four different organizations that you can get down with. As D-Rock kills us with the JB, y'all. Woo! The big payback.